Yeah, if I think no, we waited long enough, so let's start. So you faced like Yasuo. First of all, for the itemization, you built like Ninja Tab Eyes with Guardian Angel because you faced three ADs, which is totally fine in my opinion. And unfortunately, you couldn't purchase. You set it by yourself, the pickaxe and the BF sword. But then you went for Yoma's Ghost Blitz. It's good. It's not bad. So yeah, I think from item side, it's okay. Let's see what damage. What you meant with damage? Yeah, okay. You did almost. Yeah, but that's the thing. If you're behind, you. That's normal that you don't deal damage then. You know. Okay, let's start with the what. I hope the quality for you on the stream is fine. For me, it's okay. So, I think it's good. The only thing what I can't do is to check the items of the enemies and so on. And I see all minimap actions, you know. But doesn't matter, I think. Better than nothing, right? So, okay, you start here versus Yasuo. Wait in the bush. Nice Harris. Okay. So sometimes you check for the items, that's good. You started with a Doran's Blade, with a pot, pretty standard. Nice, you push for a level 2. Which. Yeah, there it is. It's important what you did there, that you pushed for level 2 early, so that Yasuo cannot use his, you know, his nasty level 2 all-in when you are still level 1, that's good. With the jumping around in the creeps and then all-inning you probably, and you have to back up, back out, and yeah. So you did fine there, for rushing for level 2, and then you should freeze the wave afterwards. The wave is slow pushing to him, but he's also pushing, so I think he doesn't really know what he does. Because for him, all what he should have done here is to wait and don't push. So that Graves, because you're on the red side and Graves could easily threat you when your wave is getting, you know, on his side. But he didn't do it, so it's all is fine. What you want to do here is to freeze the wave at your caster minion's location, I would say. Especially because of the fact that Graves could come through the dry brush. Okay, you checked for the jungler. You see your sack, so. So you can assume that he's on the same, you know, how should I call it? He's at the same jungle, on the same jungle height as Zac, because he's doing his red buff, but he did a full clear first, so that's why you did your W there to check, I guess, and yeah. So you can assume that he's at the same position as Zac at the moment. By the way, if you have any questions during the game, just write. So, Zac comes. You face checked Graves. No, you warded, right? Oh, that's unlucky. Holy shit. Wow, what damage was this? Want to see this again. Okay, so you see Zac here, right? You go toward the dry bush, because Zac is also here. So what is Zack doing at the moment? He should immediately, if you ward here and see him, he should immediately jump here, right? Graves with red buff hurts. Oh shit, you eat both Qs. Qs, sorry. Okay. Yeah, I mean, could you juke that? Not really sure. When did you flash? Okay, you flashed too late, it seems. You probably should have flashed the Yasuo Q. I mean, you don't need to flash the Graves thing because it doesn't kill you. But of course, if you get CC'd by the Yasuo Q, then it's most likely GG, or you're dead most likely. So probably you should have queued at least the Yasuo Q. You should have flashed, sorry, not queued, of course. Yeah, okay. Yeah, but that's unlucky. That Zex comes in the same time and you and Graves was waiting there. I mean, it's so unlucky. And it was so random because Zac went from from the enemy side to you and Graves was already here inside. So you might have thought that you thought that you collapsed on Graves, but Zac was really wobbly around. Yeah, I don't know why he didn't jump in. Maybe it was on cooldown. Why did he came from the river, first of all? I mean, why didn't he come from your side? That's what. Maybe he used the jump before to jump into the river. But that would be so random to use the jump for that. But yeah. Let's continue. Okay, so you're behind now. But it's not the end of the world. You got a Doran's Blade, a second Doran's Blade. I would also purchase that probably. Because that makes up for the few ex experience and maybe the items which you are behind early on. So you should be able to keep up with Yasuo after all. Graves is still here. Do you see you saw him, right? Didn't you saw him? You see him? Because of the ward, I thought you see him. Probably you didn't see him. Not sure. Ah, okay. But that was really shit unlucky that that Zac didn't jump in and you just got you ate both Qs and yeah. It's just unlucky. I don't blame you for that. You know, you could have survived if you flash early, but you know, I know that you wanted to spare your flash for the last second. I also do this, so it's just unlucky. Okay, CSing under the tower. Now all you should do right now is to focus on CS as much as possible. You have to accept that you lost the lane or that you can't, you know, bully Yasuo out of lane, so you should just focus on CSing. And you can still outplay him. I mean, Yasuo is a champion. We all know that's not mastered by many players. Ah, you eat a minion there, right? Happens, no problem. So CSing. Nice. Nice. Nice, but you didn't get your auto attack off, so it's not so good. It wasn't a good trade. Ah, that's shit. That hurts that you didn't get the cannon there. But you, as it seems you get used to Yasuo's Q patterns. Did I say that too early? Okay, nice. Wonder how much gold you have. But yeah, you as we see. Let me check on OPGG. So you went back and got boots and longsword. Nice. Ah, you play with exhaust. I didn't see that before. Yeah, I think if you used your summoners there in the at the gank, at the first gank, you could have survived. And probably if Yasuo dived you there, you could have even killed him, probably, with exhaust and flash. But that's uncertain, you know. It could have happened. Nice. Good CSing. Yeah, one CS we gave up. So, did you ping miss? Because I think Yasuo is fucking up your mid lane right now. Oh, and there are the flaming pings, I would say. I never heard Queen in German yet, actually. Like it. Yeah, pink ward. Is this your pink ward? I didn't see that. Did you buy a pink ward? Yeah, it's your pink ward. Good. Now we have enough AD to last hit the minions under the tower easy. Nice Q. So that Yasuo is actually brain dead, to be honest. Because he's gifting you all the CS. If I were him, I would just freeze the wave and zone you out of the wave. And every time you walk up for CS, I would just all in you. But he's just pushing into your tower and that gives you all the CS. So we can be happy with that. Not lucky. Okay, they dive you. Now I'm very excited what happens. Nice. Oh my god. Aggro minions here. So now Graves has the aggro. You exhausted Yasuo. Graves dropped the aggro. But he got it again because of the fucking red buff. Holy shit, if it wouldn't have red buff, then you would survive that and kill Yasuo. Oh my god. Yeah. Let's check. Did you see? Could you have any possibility to see Graves coming? So, this one is warded, right to the golems, right? And your Tribrush is warded. There you see Graves. You saw him there. Okay, so you could have just backed off. Either that. Yeah, you should have backed off before that. But I know you didn't want to back off, right? Because of the you didn't want to lose the XP and minions. But yeah. You should have backed off when you saw Graves at your golems. Because obviously he can't kill you alone with your exhaust and flash up. But yeah. it's a risk to stay in the tower, and it didn't pay off in the end. I like how you did the replay by yourself, that it takes away the part from me to make the clip, to watch the clip once again. Okay, so your tower is gone. Graves is in your jungle. Yeah, you just want to keep the tower alive here. What items did you get? Ah, now you get Lethality. Yeah. Do I agree with that? So you had a longsword, right? Actually, I would recommend there to get ninja tab eyes first. Could you? Did you? Do you think you could have? You could have gotten ninja tab eyes or some defensive item. Because obviously you're behind, but not too far behind. So this the armor could have definitely helped you for farming. So you should have tried with ninja tab eyes and skipped the lethality item, to be honest. Even death stance would be better there. Because you have no chance to roam at the moment. Or you also don't have any chance to kill Yasuo at the moment, so lethality is... Yeah, next time just go for defensive item. Yeah, now Yasuo is roaming. I don't see if you have trinkets. If you would have trinkets, I would recommend ward you around your red buff and the dry bush. You could have also... You should get the wave here in the mid lane. Yeah. So you should have just pushed one wave instead of two and then get the mid waves. There you would have now two waves. But yeah, just small thing. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty annoying for you at the moment because you can't really go up. You have no vision in your own jungle. And you can't even stay versus a Yasuo in your minion wave right now. But you do damage, at least. Let's check what's happened next. Yeah, just safety CS under the turret. Nice, you got all the CS. You pink that Yasuo is missing. Meanwhile, your bot lane is popping off, I see. So when you see that, when you're behind, slightly behind or whatever, and your team is winning, all that counts is that you don't feed any further, you know? So you probably know that too. And that's why you just safety farm under your turret. That's good. Good decision. Yasuo has now the pressure on him because he knows his team is losing. And he has to do something, you know, and that's where Yasuo would maybe will make a mistake, maybe. But I think you should still, I mean, for sure you should still put some wards in your jungle. Actually, I don't know if you know this already, but for warding, you can always ward around the living towers of yourself, you know? So in the jungle, I mean around. So if, for example, the tier 1 tower is still there, you ward in the dry bush, in there, and so on. But if just the tier 2 tower is alive, then you ward here, around this line, you know, around the line of the living towers. That's a basic rule, I would say. Yeah, your bot lane should switch with you, swap with you to get the top tower. Alright, they are doing Herald. Meanwhile, they are bot lane to bot tower. Okay, looks good. Yeah, you can kill him there. Nice exhaust. Yeah. Easy. With a fat win. How do you send in wards like that? It's with the highlight or the recording function. When you watch your own ward, you have this red button here, and then you record it. Here. This red button. And then it will be converted to a VBM file or something like that, and you can watch it with any media player. So I didn't check now what happens here. What was that? Okay, you're the man. You made the jump backwards. Nice. I was just thinking that my player crashed. Yeah, pretty clean stuff there. Also, the stun from main was pretty good. Phew, that's risky. That was too greedy. To be honest, that was too greedy. You should get bot side and leave your bot top lane to Vayne and what's your support, Janna. Seems that Vayne doesn't agree with that. Then just pick up the top wave. Also, if you see something like this happen, you can always write in chat, please. Can we swap lanes or something to get the tower? Or just ping her and then ping assistance on the top lane, it's even easier. Wonder what Zac was doing there, because you had vision. Okay, Zac is doing the wolves meanwhile. Interesting. That's a gift to your opponent. Baltzak actually gifted Rift Herald. Alright. So Twitch is even more fucked than you, I assume. What the fuck, man? Okay. Now I know what you mean with that brain dead Wayne. Just mute the people as soon as you see they are retarded. Or you can always mute them. To be honest, there is nothing so important to not be muted. Alright, let's check the map. You see Graves is there in your jungle? Or was there? So, I don't know. It's hard to predict what you saw there, because you know you have the vision of all the players. But yeah, so still, you should stick around bot lane and hope that your bot lane is going for the top tower. I mean, it's so easy to get it for Vayne and Janna and for Zac. You see Twitch there. Now I'm excited what happens. I hope we will see a kill soon. Oh shit, you missed your Q, but you exhausted him, right? So he was surely dead there. Yeah, that's a free kill, nice. Nice macro play there. Meanwhile, Yasuo is pushing top. Yasuo is also free kill. You and Vayne together can kill him. You see him going for a red buff? I wonder what you will do. Will you gift it to him? No, you fly there already. Okay, but it's too late. Unlucky. Orianna's pinging to push for the tower, but didn't even check the wave. Holy shit. Bye bye, Vayne. Okay, but you kill him, I guess. Nice. Nice plate. And now you should run for your life. Will you die there? Holy shit, it was close. Holy shit, man, that was so unlucky that you didn't hit him there. But nice pickup on Graves before. Nice. That's a Baron. Eat him. Yeah, that's a Baron for you guys. Yeah, at least it's not so tilting this time, because you didn't see it in game, I guess. You just saw it in the replay, right? But yeah, that should be a Baron there. If you kill three people. All Or at least a tower, yeah. Of course you can do a tower as well, but I just say that it could be a baron instead. Probably with Graves alive, it's safer to go for a tower. I mean the top tower, you know, not the mid tower. Of course it was too late then. Yeah, just get the side waves. I think you should get a pink ward. Just saw you purchase one pink ward in the game, right? Yeah, just defend the tower. You have static shift already, that so it's easy for you to defend. Just kill the wave. Oh, you could have just... You could have... In my opinion, you could have just walked here when he was there. Because as soon as you're here, you're in tower range. And when he jumps on you, he can't kill you at that time. Yeah, now walk into the tower and should be fine. But yeah. Oh, you, I think you checked the minimap at that time, right? And saw that your team is fighting. Well played. What are you doing at the moment? I see, just see you fighting there with Graves. Oh my god, close as fuck. Yeah, nice Q. You hit everything perfectly. Then he hit his Q, you flashed out, exhausted him. Close. Let me check what items Graves had. He might had Duskblade and Death Stance at this stage of the game, I guess. So hard to fight a Death Stance Graves with only Lethality item and a Static Shift. But you could have done it. Probably just flash earlier. I think it's always like that. If you in this game, if you flashed the Q before earlier, you could have survived. And even here, if you flashed Graves' smoke screen, whatever it's called, earlier, then it would save you at least one auto attack, which would be making the difference. And also, of course, the exhaust would be gone off earlier. So Twitch is coming here. Holy shit! Did you have everything on cooldown? Once again. So you're farming. Okay, you used your Q. Okay, yeah, nothing you could do there. Yeah, without the Q, you couldn't survive that. So if you... Yeah, I mean, I do it like that. If I have static shift in that stage of the game, and I don't use Q anymore. If I split push in side lanes, I know that there can come somebody, you know, and kill me if I don't have my Q up. That would be maybe a good tip for the next time. that you just farm with your auto attacks with static shift. Ja, so. Top tower still standing, by the way. Probably it's now your time to push top. Because you have some items right now for split pushing. I don't like it that you group there, to be honest. At least, yeah, bot or top wave. Bot is also fine. Don't tell me that he steals it. Oh my god. Just let him die, please. Just run. Okay, you're dead. That sucks. Let's watch that again, yeah. But at least your team survived, because of you sacrificed it you for them, and you got the Drake. So at the end, it's not dope, not so bad. Nice, good pick. Did you cancel his ult there with your E? Looked like that, but I can't check it. You saw Graves there, right? Because of the ward at the red buff, didn't you? Yeah. Dex should come with you. What? Why is he going back? That was so free to get Graves there. And if Graves is dead, who knows, maybe you could have gone for Baron. Okay, that should... What? I wanted to say that should be now a kill on Graves, but seems he's too tanky. Just go for the top wave. Now you should go bot. Oh shit. Okay, you've got two ultimates, I guess. I think Twitch also ulted, right? We got two heavy cooldowns. Holy shit. Okay. 1 for 1. I mean 2 for 1. Still, I think you group too much in this game, to be honest. You could have, you could get much more gold and experience if you split pushed top wave so often. Okay, yeah. If you cannot count on Orianna, then I understand the defensive flash there. But yeah. In this game, you shoot more split. Double DC. Oh my god. Der Highlight. Nice. Just stay defensive. As long as the two guys are DC'd, you might even give up the inhibitor there. Twitch is bot lane. What is Orianna doing there? Why is she fighting them when she knows that two guys of you are DC'd? Just clear the waves and don't let them get any more towers or objectives. Alright, yeah, get the top wave. Good. You saw Graves in the jungle because he walked over the red ward there. So he might be dead there, the Graves, hopefully, not the Vayne. Yeah, nice. Top wave. Or bot wave. But not mid wave. Look at the juicy wave on the bot lane. Holy shit, that's gold. That's so much gold there. Damn man. That's not worth. That's not good that you team fighted there. I mean, yeah, you were 5 and so on. But you forced it somehow. Or Zac forced it. Vayne is low, so two auto attacks of. Holy shit, look at the Twitch damage. And at least when that happened, you should immediately just recognize, okay, we can't fight them, so you should just back off. Probably during the. Through the river, top side. But what is he doing? Why is he jumping in again? I think he baited you like 3 times already in the death. Before, when you were 5 people, you could have teamfighted them. But even then, it's more worth to get a juicy wave at the top or bot lane for you. And let your team maybe push or something. But now, when you're just 3 because the other two guys got killed by Twitch, it's unwinnable to teamfight there. So, if Zac jumps in there, just say goodbye, Zac, and fly back to base or something and get the bot wave. It's much, much more worth than teamfighting there. That surely would be a Baron there, no? Okay, they go for inhibitor. Because you're aced and nobody could tank. Maybe Yasuo could have tanked Baron. 2 inhibs. Go, 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 go! Nice, well played. Too greedy by them also. Bot wave. I want to see an offline bot wave. Please. Please. Holy shit. How did you eat the raptor there when you were in smoke screen? I wonder. That's close. Damn. I was surprised actually that you could kill Twitch there. I thought that Twitch already finished you off. Really, was it? Why? can recheck this again. My thought was that dash away. But you wanted to kill him, right? So you're smoke screened. You can't see the raptors, to be honest, but maybe you warded them before you couldn't see anything, right? Ah, you just wanted to E him or to show that you E him, but then to force a flash, right? That was your thought process there. There actually I thought normally when I face twitches they would get a double kill there. But you did it good before Rihanna together. Yeah, of course you could have tried to juke the Graves ultimate, you know, but I don't blame anyone for dying there. Yeah. But that's weird. That's a weird style. Could you even have eat him there? Do you remember? Or did you just see the raptor? Nice, your team is doing Baron. For free. Nice. Bye bye, Wayne. Don't tell me she kills him. No. The safe play, okay. Yeah, just stay safe and kill the wave when it comes to your inhibitor. Your team has Baron buff, I wonder what they are doing. Just kill Yasuo. Nice. Yeah, it's okay. I mean, if it was intended, then it's fine. You know, if I E a minion, then it's mostly not intended. But if it was your plan, then I don't blame it for that. If you would have forced a flash there, it would be totally worth. Nice. Damn it, that was one auto attack, are you kidding me? Nice stopwatch there. Although, yeah, it was good that your team was next to you. You have 3 inhibitors down, right? Popping off, finally, yeah? Yeah, okay, with the static shift Infinity Edge. No wonder that you cut through the well codes. I think you only are in the game there because you killed the Baron before. Because with three inhibitors down, it's very, very hard. Now I'm excited what's happening. Okay, you wait here. You probably... Damn, Zac is going in again. Like a retard. This Zac man. No comment to him. So only Yasuo could it be, right? Your same level as him? But he's already full build and he's pretty tanky. So going for a last whisper there is totally fine. Because you saw that he has an armor item and a Asterix gauge. Now we got the time scale. What's happening now? Will we see now a pentakill or what? Okay, Orianna is doing a good job there. Go for Yasuo or Backcourts. Go for Backcourts. Oh, sorry, my phone is ringing. Nice. Nice. You wait for Twitch to pop up, right? But yeah, you can just go for the tower. Just save your Q. Exactly. Now you can kill Twitch. Nice. That's the perfect scenario there. Wait for him to pop up, instantly Q him. Of course he can one-shot you, or he can two-shot you, right, normally. But if you shoot your Q early like that, then with your team together, you can easily kill him afterwards, after he is blinded. Yeah, nice game. I mean, the key factors which I remember there is that you didn't use your summoners early to survive some cases like the gank and the 1v1 versus Graves in the jungle. And but that's not now game changing or something. I mean, it's game changing for you probably if you have to play from behind from the like third minute or something. But the important thing I would say is that you often lost gold because of not going for split pushing at the side lanes. This game I went hard thinking like a tank. Champion and grouping too much. Yeah, exactly. You group too much. I think Yasuo, let's add like 400 CS at the end. And you had 250. You could have the same amount of CS as him. To be honest, if you would have split pushed a lot more. And especially, I mean, sometimes it's good if you know if you group. But then you need a team you can group with, and the Suicide Zac is, in my opinion, not a teammate I want to group with. But yeah, that's the two basic stuff, the basic things I remember of this game. So split pushing, getting more CS. You felt so vulnerable? You mean for split pushing you felt vulnerable or? Yeah, I mean, sure, it's dangerous versus a Twitch and so on if you split push, especially if you're behind. But I think you purchased only one pink ward this game. With a pink ward, you can ward in your in. I showed you the tower line, you know, where you could have ward always around the living towers, you know. At least one pink ward, and also your jungle. Generally, wasn't warded really often, as I remember. I think you could have warded there more often. In the mid game, I mean. But yeah. And you could also like play around the Twitch, you know, that you don't just randomly split push, but only split push if you see Twitch popping up somewhere on the map. And you go on the other side of the map because you're a queen, you know. You're fucking hyperspeed chat. But yeah, all in all, you played it pretty safe, and in the end, you won it. And yeah, that's basically it. Any other questions from your side? I will ask Queen Mastermind if we